Sea Shepherd was set up in 1977 as an anti-poaching organization because we have all the rules, regulations, and the treaties that we need to protect our oceans, but we don't have any enforcement because of a lack of political and economic will and on the part of governments. So I decided there was a need for an organization to enforce those international regulations. Sea Shepherd's a volunteer organization, depends on volunteers. I mean, that's the kind of passion that we couldn't hire anybody to exercise in the field. So I prefer volunteers over professionals. This organization survives because of the volunteers on the ship, the volunteers on shore, and our support base on land. In 1975, we'd come up with this idea to protect whales by putting our bodies between the whales and the whalers. And we knew a lot of Gandhi at the time, and we thought that this would be a tactic that would work. And Robert Hunter and I found ourselves in a small boat in front of a Soviet harpoon vessel. It was about 60 miles off the northern coast of California. And in front of us were 8 sperm whales that were fleeing for their life. And every time the harpooner tried to get a shot, I'd block the path of the harpoon and prevent the shot. And this was working for about 25 minutes. And then the Soviet captain came down the catwalk of the whaler and screamed into the ear of the harpooner, then turned and looked at us, smiled, and cut his finger across his throat. And that's when I realized that, you know, Gandhi wasn't going to work for us that day. And a few moments later, there was this incredible explosion flew over our head and hit one of the whales, this female, in the back, and she screamed and rolled on her side. It was like a woman screaming. It was very, very haunting. And suddenly, the largest whale in the pod hit the water with his tail and disappeared and dove and swam right underneath of us. And he hurled himself out of the water straight at the harpooner on the Soviet vessel. But they were waiting for him with an unattached harpoon, and he pulled the trigger and hit him at point-blank range. And this big bull sperm whale screamed and fell back in the water in agony, blood everywhere. And as he was rolling on the surface, and I caught his eye, he dove again, and this time I saw a trail of bloody bubbles coming at us real fast. And he came up and out of the water at an angle so that the next move was to fall forward and fall right on top of us. And as his head rose up out of the water and I saw his eye appear, and I looked into this eye, and that's when I saw understanding, that the whale understood what we were trying to do. And I could see the effort he made to pull himself back, and his head began to sink beneath the sea, and I saw his eye disappear beneath the surface, and he died. And so he could have killed us and chose not to do so. So I'm personally indebted to that whale for the fact that I'm alive. But I also saw something else in his eye, and that was pity. And not for himself, but for us, that we could take life so thoughtlessly, so remorselessly, and for what? What were the Russians killing these whales for? It wasn't for meat, it was for spermaceti oil, sperm oil used for lubricating high heat resistant equipment and machinery. And one of the things that they were building with this machinery is intercontinental ballistic missiles. And so I said, here we are destroying this incredibly intelligent, beautiful, socially complex, sentient creature for the purpose of making a weapon meant for the mass extermination of people. And that's when it struck me, you know, we're just insane, you know. And from that day on, I said, you know, I'm going to do this for whales and sharks and turtles and fish, but not for people, so I don't really care what people think about what we do. The most important thing to consider if we're going to have a future is the protection of biodiversity, especially in the oceans. If the oceans die, then civilization collapses and humanity goes extinct. It's as simple as that. This is not the planet Earth, it's the planet ocean. And the oceans are absolutely essential for our survival. Right now, every single commercial fishery is in a state of collapse. The oceans are in trouble, the oceans are dying. I don't think of anything on this planet that is more important than the protection of our oceans, which is really the protection of our biosphere. That's more important than any other social issue that we can even imagine, because without a healthy oceans, there is no future.